Mr. Doherty, how about I turn things over to you to start, and then we'll hear from the principal and the teacher. Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine. First of all, I want to thank you for doing this again. This is always a great thing every year, and we look forward to it. And it's such a nice thing. I think that the volumes of things I could say about the last 6 weeks, it's just been something else. But to be able to do this and see some faces and talk to some people again is just wonderful. And I just want to offer my congratulations. You know, it's a great family, great kids, and great members of the community. And we're just so happy that this is where we ended up. I wish we could do it in person. I'm sorry we can't. But we're very proud. And I think Mr. Schaefer and Mr. Sherwood can get into some more of the specific accomplishments as you spend your days with them, but knowing you and your family personally, you're wonderful people, and so pleased, and you're so deserving. So congratulations.
Yeah, very cool. Mr. Schaefer, Mr. Sherwood, I'm going to offer some remarks, and then I'll just talk to Liv a little bit about how we arrived here, and talk to you a little bit about the program.
Sure. And I'll just add on that I'm really happy we were able to do this again. Like Mr. Doherty, I wish it was in person, but I'm glad we're doing it, because when we first shut down, I was afraid that we wouldn't be able to recognize Livia. She definitely deserves it. It's nice to see the kids grow over the 4 years that we have them here, and she's grown quite a bit and turned into just a great example of what we value here in Newark Valley. She's hardworking, she's a good friend, she's kind, she's always smiling. Really proud to kind of show her off and to recognize all of her hard work and all the good things she does. I can't remember too many times where I see her in the hall and she's not smiling or hanging out with her friends and just being nice. And as we know, especially during these times, that's just as important, if not more important, than all the good grades she gets and what she does. Mr. Sherwood will talk a little more about that, but being kind and having a positive attitude and just adding a lot to our middle school, we're just really proud of you. So congratulations. You are well deserving of this recognition. So congrats. Great job.
Liv, we couldn't be more proud of you. You're exactly what we want as a student. You're a joy to see in the hallway. You're always smiling. It's fun to pop into your classes and see you. Your ability to juggle everything that you do is amazing, from playing the tuba in the band to being in the court, to be the leading scorer on the basketball team, to soccer skills, everything. You're exactly what we want as a student. And I'd also like to reach out for what you're doing with the community right now. It's very important. I see you in the store shopping for people that can't get out. And for a 12-year-old to take their time to reach out. And your family is such an important part of our community. And you're following right in their footsteps. And we're real proud of you, Liv. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, if we could give you a big round of applause, we would. But as Mr. Doherty and the principal and the teacher said, we prefer to do this in person, but we can't, of course. And a couple of years ago, the team and I, my staff and I, we created this student recognition program because in conjunction with the school districts, because we thought, at least internally, that all too often adults got all the credit for the good things that were happening in the community. And we thought it really important to join forces with the school districts throughout my Senate district and do our part in using the voices and the platforms that we have to shine a bright light on all the good things that young people are doing. After all, you're the future, right? There'll come a time when we are all tired and sitting on our couches and you guys are out in the community doing great things. But apparently you're not going to wait until you get older, because you're already doing that now. So I just wanted to take some time today and first and foremost thank everybody for joining us and being able to do this using technology. Again, we'd rather do it in person, but I'm glad we get an opportunity to do this, because you certainly deserve the recognition for all the good things that you're doing. I'm just going to glance at my paper, if it'd be okay. I want to just remark on some of the things that your school district said about you. said that you're a self-motivated student who is a leader among her peers in the classroom and outside of the classroom. You exhibit academic success and integrity every day that you're in school and that you're out in the community. I understand that you're fourth in your class. You have an overall average of 97. What an accomplishment. I was happy with a 79 in school. Not happy to admit that, but 97 is that's pretty amazing. You have a wonderful work ethic. Your homework is always done, and you have found a way to manage not only your academics, but also your sports career and all that you're doing out in the community. So apparently you have many commitments, not just academic, but also community commitments and athletic commitments. And being so young, I think it's very hard to juggle those things, but apparently you're doing very, very well at that. So who are you joined with here today? Your mom and dad, naturally. Is that your sister?
Yeah, my sister, Cameron.
Okay. Younger, older? Younger, okay. How are you guys staying busy during this challenging time?
Lots of homework, been baking, and I've been helping out at my family's grocery store.
Wonderful. I'm glad that you led with homework, because Mr. Doherty and Mr. Schaefer and Mr. Sherwood would want to hear that. Has your time been okay away from school?
Yeah.
Been challenging?
Yeah, kind of. It's just been kind of boring.
Yeah, it's challenging for all of us, really. It really is. I mean, I think there's a great sense of wanting to get back to some normalcy in life, but you know, I think at least at the governmental level, and you know, whether it be locally or statewide or in the school district, everybody's just trying to make the best decisions possible to keep everybody safe, get you all the things that you need, and you know, just be as safe as possible. Do you have any suggestions to your peers or other people in the community about how they can get through this crisis that we're in, or quite frankly, any advice to them about just being a good citizen like you clearly are?
Just to enjoy the time at home with your family and just stay safe.
Yeah, that's the greatest thing. And I heard a couple of words I just want to talk about just very, very quickly. And then I know everybody's time is valuable, but, you know, the folks that deal with you every day say that you have values and that you are kind and that you have you're making an investment in the community. I can't think of three greater things that a person or an attribute or attributes that people could have to make the community better. You know, I grew up in the small town of Afton, right? A lot like the township that you're in. And, you know, small town values are incredibly important. I would argue that with anyone any day of the week. I think the things that you learn in a small town about taking care of your community, taking care of your neighbors, things that you're currently doing, you can take that with you through life, whether you end up in Manhattan or in North Dakota. Those things that you're portraying now, those values that you have now, you can take through life. So taking care of the community is important in times of crisis like this, but just even generally speaking, right, as a normal course of business. If more people were like you, I would respectfully argue the world would be a much, much better place. So again, just want to congratulate you. I'm so happy that your family is with us, so your mom and dad and your sister, your grandparents. I think that's pretty special to be able to have them join us. And so again, wanted to congratulate you. Going to send you a few things. The UPS man will deliver it. I'm going to send you a certificate of achievement, a t-shirt, and a challenge coin, if you'll indulge me for just one moment. On the back of the challenge coin, it is inscribed. It says, "Work hard and dream big." And we put that on the back of the challenge coin because it was important to me growing up in a small town of Afton for young people like yourself to know that no matter where we come from, no matter how big our home is or what kind of shoes we wear on our feet or how much money we have in our wallet, you can do anything you want in life, anything. All you have to do is work hard at it. There'll be people that come along that try to stand in your way kindly. Push them out of the way and continue to move forward and follow your dreams, and you'll be incredibly successful. I promise you that. Okay. Mm-hmm. Mr. Doherty, you want to wrap it up?
Yeah. I just want to, you know, look, congratulations. You're a wonderful student, but that's, you know, I think as everyone said here, the point of this is that, you know, you're a wonderful person, and that's the most important thing. And we're really proud of you. And like Mr. Sherwood said, seeing you working away and helping others out in the community and throughout this, you know, when I come in, seeing you there. By the way, did you get the day off today? Or do you have to?
Yeah, she did.
good. Because I know mom's keeping busy, but you know, you're one of the good ones, and you got a bright future, and we're proud to have you.
Thanks.
So, Liv, if there's anything that my team or I can ever do for you, we are happy to do that, and I say that with the utmost sincerity. Now, the only thing that you need to do is pick up the phone and say, "This is Livia Short, and I want to talk. I want to talk to the senator, and they'll find me and get me on the phone. And I mean that with the utmost sincerity. If there's something that I can do for you or your family, please let us know. And Mr. Doherty will attest to that. I mean what I said. So again, congratulations, Grandma and Grandpa. I'm sorry. I don't want to. We're certainly not ignoring you. Anything you'd like to add?
I don't know. Can you guys hear us? Oh, yeah. My camera went out and I didn't know I could hear you.
We're just all very proud of her. Very proud of her. She's been a good kid all the way around for many years. And good thing you can't see us because I'm about ready to cry.
Congratulations, Liv.
Thank you.
We love you. Who did I miss? Mr. and Mrs. Hollenbeck, is that right?
Yeah, we're here. We're just not on camera. I don't know what happened.
I was on. Mine went out. I don't know what happened.
We see you.
That's what happens when your grandparents. Hey, congratulations, Liv.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Liv.
Thanks.
Liv, again, congratulations. We're all very, very proud of you. Thank you for taking some time so we could do this. The UPS man will be around in a couple of weeks. And from the bottom of my heart, congratulations. Great job. Keep up the good work. And I hope everybody on the line stays safe, stays healthy. And God bless you all.
And back to you, too.
Yep. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yep. Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.